in everything we do, we're actually bound by mental models. We know what a hotel should look like. We walk in and almost don't need to see anything. Here's a reception. All of that is part of our mental model for a hotel. What a hotel room looks like, what a restaurant looks like, what the breakfast is, all of that is part of the mental model, the mindset for a hotel. And we never really think about it. The same goes for the mindset for business. We never really think about it. And the point I would like to raise is that we need to think about it. It is the same mental model, designed for a totally different time, that we are now applying in the 21st century, where we not only have computers and social media, the internet, but we also have a group of young people growing up who have been sort of born with a mobile phone, more or less, and who are part of various social networks and who just can't understand that at least my generation in general is not so much happy with Facebook and whatever they are part of. So we are looking upon a workforce that is totally different from us and actually totally different from what was the case 100 years ago. I am one of the few people that actually write a weblog, a blog. This will help you build up social capital. Within 6 months' time, I had 10,000 people following my weblog on a regular basis. And since it was upon the publishing of the book, over time, there's a community being built up around that book, which is now 5 years old, and that is social capital. It means that I usually very often need a person for this, a person for that, what have you. So I'm actually just doing a tweet. If it's an important job, I'm doing a blog post. I'm saying, okay, who knows the best person for this particular function? And within 24 hours, I always have 10 good candidates. And that's social capital. You have a community that you're part of, and that can actually, the fact that you have this social capital, you can transform it into value. We created the Spaghetti Organization. And Spaghetti Organization, to make a point very simply, is that you imagine a company which is just a group of people like we are here, and then you take away the titles, the departments, the offices, the job descriptions, everything. You just take it away and you liberate every single person to do his or her best. That's the idea. What we did was to introduce mechanisms that actually substituted the work of the management. There were three basic mechanisms. One was a mechanism of getting things done, which was a project structure in which each employee would choose which projects he or she would be involved in. There would be a project leader for each project, and for every 10 to 20 projects, there would be a project owner. And in that structure, no person could do only one thing. Everybody had to do at least three things, and two of these three should be something that the person was not formally qualified to do. Okay. Second mechanism is the mechanism of keeping the professional quality, the professional level of what we do at a high standard. And this works like this. For every profession needed to do this type of work, could be mechanical construction or audiology or marketing or whatever, for every profession, we appointed the best guru. And every employee would attach him or herself to whatever number of gurus that they thought was relevant. So if you were a chip designer, you'd obviously attach yourself to the chip, to the chief, fantastic design guru, but you might also be interested in customer service, and you would attach yourself to the guru for that. Third mechanism is a people mechanism, which is that for every 10 or 15 people, we would appoint a mentor. We would appoint slightly more mentors than we needed, and then we would allow and encourage the staff to choose who should be my boss. So each would choose his or her mentor. And some of the people that were originally appointed, nobody chose them. And this was a fantastic opportunity to spot the bad leaders and make them specialists, okay? Because you know you know the system. So there are three mechanisms: a project, profession, and people mechanism. And these three mechanisms combined with a number of others within a value system, that is sufficient to run a company without a management structure.